See that all living things seem to have some common characteristics. They all need food, respire, respond to stimuli, reproduce, show movement, grow, and die. Do we find some non-living things that also show some of these characteristics? Cars, bicycle, clocks, and the water in the river move. The moon moves in the sky. A cloud grows in size right in front of our eyes. Can you such things be called living? We ask ourselves, do these objects also show all the other characteristics of living things? In general, something that is living may have all the characteristics that we discussed, while non-living things may not show all these characteristics at the same time. Is this always true? Do we also find that living things definitely show all the characteristics of the living that we have discussed? Do we also find that non-living things may show only some of these characteristics and never all of them? To understand this a little better, let us look at a specific example. Consider any seed, say moong. Is it living? It can stay in a shop for 6 months and not show any growth or some of the other characteristics of life. However, we bring the same seed and a plant in it in, water it, and it turns into a whole plant. Did the seed need food? Did it excrete, grow, or reproduce when it was in the shop for many months? We see that there can be cases when we cannot easily say that a thing has all the characteristics that we have discussed for it to call living. What then is life? Push your hand deep inside a sack of wheat. Do you find it is warm inside? There is some heat being produced inside the sack of wheat. The seeds respire and that process give out some heat. We see that respiration is a process that takes place in the seeds even when some of the other life processes may not be very active. It may not be very easy to answer our question, what then is life? However, looking at all the diversity of living beings around us, we can conclude that life is beautiful.